Hello, Werewolf Army, this is Jaden's Videos, and I am back with another Wolfman review, and this is a very, very special Wolfman review, because this is my first Wolfman review of a new for 2019 Spirit Halloween animatronic, and this is of Waving Wally. I got this today at a Spirit Halloween store 1 hour from my house. It wasn't my local one. My local one does open tomorrow, so I'll be going back tomorrow and most likely getting Headless Help, so there will be a review on Headless Help tomorrow. But I had to get Wally today because, yeah, like I've said before, I have, or had, at now, no life-size clown props. And I love clowns. They are honestly probably my third favorite Halloween monsters right after, fourth favorite, sorry, right after werewolves, demons, and scarecrows. Then it's clowns. I absolutely love clowns. But I have no life-size clowns, and the reason why is because every year, they are never my number one priority, the clown props are. Usually, actually for the past 2 years, the clown prop that's been released has been my fourth favorite. And that's the case for this year too. Usually they're my fourth favorite. And so since they're not up in my top three, I mean, fourth favorite is still really high, but I usually try to get my main favorites first and then get down further into the list. But I figured that is not working when the fourth favorite happens to be a clown, because as we all know, clowns are very popular, and so they sell out very fast. When I went to get Creepy Towering Clown in 2017, he was gone. Last year, my store didn't even get a Hugs, or if they did, it sold out before I could even get the chance to see it. And, I mean, I saw Hugs in person, they never got one in the box that I was able to see. So, I figured this year, Waving Wally has to be the first or second prop I got this year, and the store I went to did not have a Headless Help. So, I decided to get Wally today because I want to get him before he sells out because he's a clown. I'm not 100% sure if he's going to sell out, but usually the clowns do, so it was something that I had to go with because I needed a life-size clown. And this is my second favorite clown that we've ever gotten, if not my favorite. I don't know. I'm kind of second-guessing my favorite. My favorite before was Silent and Deadly because I absolutely love the whole vintage clown appearance. They're my favorite types of clowns. I think they're honestly terrifying. And I do love all clowns, but honestly, the ones that are creepy to me, because clowns don't scare me. I honestly think they're really cool. And they don't scare me. Like, Hugs the Clown, he doesn't scare me. I think he's awesome, but he doesn't scare me. Whereas Waving Wally, I have a kind of unnerving, creeped out feeling around him because he is a vintage clown, and they just look a lot creepier. And that is one of the main reasons that I like him, but there's also other reasons that I like him, and I will get into that. But my fourth favorite prop of the year, had to get him, so here is the review. Anyways, so this is my first life-size clown prop. I'm so happy, I feel so accomplished, I'm so happy right now. I have clowns, but they're all tabletops, and the biggest clown that I have is Roaming Antique Clown, up until this guy. I feel so accomplished with my life, I finally have a life-size clown. So, here's Waving Wally. I love his vintage appearance that he has. It's so creepy, but something I really like about him, as much as I love Hugs the Clown and Creepy Towering Clown, they're more like monster clowns. They like have sharp claws, sharp teeth and stuff, and I think it's cool, but I don't like when every clown has that or a deep voice. I like clowns with high-pitched, jumpy voices or, you know, clowns that actually look human, because clowns are just supposed to be psychopathic humans dressed as clowns who go around killing people, most preferably kids. So that's always the type of clown that I've liked best, and we don't get very many of those clowns, and that's one of the main reasons I love Waving Wally. He just looks like a normal person dressed as a clown, and it's terrifying. It just makes it so much creepier than any other clown, and I just love it, honestly. I think it's super cool, and they pulled this off very well. He really does look like a vintage clown. His whole black and white color scheme is just great. I absolutely love it. Everything about him is awesome. The detail on his face is really good. You can tell he has creases and wrinkles in his face, so he's actually supposed to be a real person. This is plastic, and usually latex props are preferable to plastic. Of course, there's still a lot of good props made with plastic, but usually latex props just look better detail-wise, but in his case, I think plastic head looks perfect for him because they were able to get in all those details. Honestly, looks phenomenal. You can see also he doesn't have a completely whited out face. It is white, but you can also see kind of skin color showing through. a little bit, and I like that, because like the makeup, you can actually tell that it's makeup, and it's not just a white out face. It's, you can tell it's supposed to be makeup, and I really like that. He's got blonde hair, which is very different, not something we've seen for a clown, but you know, it works better with the vintage clown appearance, because when vintage clowns were a thing, they didn't really usually dye their hair or wear wigs or anything. They usually just went with their normal hair color. So I like that he's blonde. It definitely also adds to the vintage look, because it adds to the black and white type of feel. Because though blonde isn't white, it's closer to white than, let's say, green or something. If he had green hair, it just wouldn't fit as well. So I like it. His face detail is really good, like I said. I love the black eyes. Those do light up, of course, but they look great. His little hat, very small little vintage clown hat. I really like it. His hands are really nicely detailed too. He's wearing gloves. You can see the creases and everything in it. It's very nice. And I'll show you this one down here, so you can see something I really like with his hands. If you could see it, there's little black stripes under there. Now, who does that remind you of? Because to me, that reminds me of Mickey Mouse's gloves. And the reason I love that is because that's how cartoons and stuff like Mickey Mouse, and there's other cartoons, I believe Bugs Bunny has them too. That's how they were usually drawn, with gloves, with like black lines on the back of them. And so it gives them definitely more of a vintage feel, but it also adds to that cartoonish feel of a clown. So it's like a vintagey, cartoony clown, which I really, really like. I think it really looks awesome. His suit is just normal quality of a life-size prop costume. Not really any different from something you'd find on like Harbinger of Hell or Barnyard Butcher. Looming Strawman's got a little more burlap feel. I think the feeling of this one that I can best compare it to would probably be Pumpkin Patch Prowler, at least with props that I have in my room currently that I can look at and compare it to. He's got this little neck collar, collar around his neck. Looks really nice. I don't know if it's supposed to be blood or not there. I would assume it's just faded blood. It doesn't have a red appearance, but usually if blood's like dry onto clothes like this, it would usually look like that. I don't know if it's blood or just dirt, but either way, it's really adds to the detail. Of course, he's got white down one side, a tannish white type look. It's more tan down one side, and then black with white polka dots on the other side, then the three pom-poms down the middle. And then you move down to his shoes. These are massive shoes. They're just black plastic, black hollow plastic, just like most prop shoes, but they're really massive. Not much detail, of course, because they're just the shoes. Usually the shoes don't have too good of detail, but you know, they've got a little bit here and there. They're very big though, of course, because he's a clown. So that's his appearance. I already tested out his constant motion, and I don't know if I'll do it in this video or not, because I think we all know, I think we've all seen what his constant motion is like by now. It's pretty much just his phrases, just continuous movement. It pauses for like 0.1 seconds, and then it starts back up again. So it's like, it's mainly constant. Now, constant motion is something that Spirit's really highlighting this year in a lot of props. But the thing is, constant motion has been a thing for, since like 2012, as far back as I can remember. The original Limb Ripper had constant motion. Nightmare Harvester has it. Looming Strawman has it. Pumpkin Patch Prowler has it. Barnyard Butcher has it. So many props have constant motion. But usually in their constant motion, they would pause for 1 or 2 seconds and then do their cycle again. So it's not the same as this year, where it just keeps on moving and it doesn't even really pause. And I like this a lot better, how it doesn't pause. And some props like Tortured Torso, Graveyard Ghoul, and Waving Wally, for example, I think it works really well. My only thing I would have to say, and this is something else a lot of people are saying, is durability. If you have the prop going non-stop, it's going to break down a lot easier. But from what I've seen, my Limb Ripper, I use him on constant motion, have used him on constant motion ever since 2012. Now, it's not the same constant motion. Like I said, it pauses for a few seconds. But it's the same type of thing where he just keeps going throughout the night, and he's still perfectly fine. And so I'd assume that, even though that's an older prop, I would assume that these props are going to last just about the same as any older prop that had the semi-constant motion type thing to it. I don't know, but you just can't overuse it. You should only do constant motion every now and then, like on Halloween night, I would think would be the best time to do constant motion. That way, whenever someone's walking by him in a haunt, it's for sure that he's gonna go off, especially with him because his pom-poms kind of cover his sensor. You can, of course, move it up a little bit, and you could probably try to reposition it, but his pom-poms kind of cover his sensor. But so definitely for on Halloween night, you would want to have him constant motion, so no matter who walks by him, they're always going to see him going, and they'll always see his activation, which I really like. But I think he'll last good enough if you don't do it all the time. Just certain occasions, like Halloween night and maybe some other time throughout the season. I wouldn't do it all the time, though. But without any further ado, I'm going to show you what this guy does. And I really do love his motion. Let me just say I love it. It's very creepy and subtle. And I really like it. I think the waving, the slow waving, is just awesome. And then I'll talk about his audio after I show you what he does. So without any further ado, here we go.
Everybody has good childhood memories of carnival. Follow me. I promise we will give you some new memories you will never forget. I'll introduce you to the boss, but all applicants must be dead. That's not a problem, is it?
Alright, first let me just say the voice acting on this one is phenomenal. If I am 100% correct, and I believe that I am, there could be that 1% chance, so I'm going to say 0.1% chance, so I'm going to say I'm 99.9% sure this is voiced by Mike, because it does... It sounds kind of like his voice. There's some props where you know they're voiced by him because, you know, the deep voices, his deep voices sound familiar sometimes. It's like, oh, that sounds like him. But like this one, he definitely uses a much different voice than a deep voice that he's used before. And so it's kind of hard to tell, but from what I've heard of his normal speaking voice, this sounds kind of similar to it. It's just a little more high-pitched, of course. But it sounds very similar, so I think Mike did it, and if he did, great job, Mike. This is honestly one of my favorite props he's voiced, because it's just so subtle and creepy. I really like the voice on this one, much more than I like the voice on Hugs, because he's got a deep voice. I think clowns should have more high-pitched and, you know, subtle voices than a deep, growly voice that sounds kind of demonic. I mean, Crouchy's case, I think it works very well because he's very large and demonic looking, but for like a prop like this, him having a deep voice wouldn't work. I really like his high-pitched voice. I think it's very cool and very creepy. His motion is great. It's very subtle and disturbing to just see this clown just waving at you. I really like how his eyes and nose light up. I love the fading effect to it. It looks awesome. And I love his background music. The kind of old-fashioned circus music, I really like how it sounds. And another thing that I like is how the children in the background of the audio, they're all laughing and giggling at the beginning, and then as the phrase progresses on, you can start hearing them kind of like crying and wailing. So it's like they're starting to realize what's up with this clown. So anyways, I really like it. I think it's very cool. And my only complaint with this, I really only have one complaint, and is the price tag of $229.99. I think it's pretty overpriced for him. I don't get me wrong, I love this prop. I think he's great. But some of the props this year of Spirit are just very overpriced. I mean, some have really great prices, like Jack Straw and Demonic Dahlia and stuff. But some of them have pretty high prices, and I mean... Like, I love this prop, so I was going to get it no matter what the price was. But it's high for this guy. I think if you're not very certain about him, I don't know, maybe think about it, because it is a lot of money to be spending on him. But if you really want him, then I guess go for it, no matter what the price is. If you're willing to pay it for this guy, go for it. But he's got a high price. I think $200 would have been better, because that's like the basic... 6 foot price, like a prop with like one or two animations that's 6 feet tall, usually they're priced at $200. Whereas he only has one animation and he's 230. I don't really know the reason why they made him 230. Maybe the whole constant motion thing, maybe his lights, how they fade in and out, maybe because he's big, because he is very tall. He is, especially with his waving hand. It definitely is very large. It actually reaches up taller. No, I think it's as tall as Nightmare Harvester, because I have Nightmare Harvester across my room. I'm kind of comparing. It's as tall as Nightmare Harvester with his hand fully raised up. I mean, from his head to his hat, it's not that, but with his hand fully raised up, it is as tall as Nightmare Harvester. So he's very tall, but I don't know why he's 230. He should be 200 in my opinion, but I'm not going to take away any claw marks for that just because it's only one complaint. So I'm just going to give him 5 out of 5 claw marks because besides the price, he is a great prop in my opinion. And for someone who really wants a really creepy and subtle clown, I think this is the best that you can get. So anyways, I hope you all enjoyed this Wolfman review. Stay tuned for my next spirit walkthrough coming tomorrow, which Hauntformer is going to be in, and I would assume he's going to make a video that I'm going to be in. So stay tuned for that tomorrow, and also stay tuned for a review on Headless Help tomorrow. Keep howling at the moon, my werewolves.
Hey, come back. You don't play fair, and you're making me angry. But maybe if you subscribe to Jaden's videos and join the werewolf army, I'll let you live another day. But it's not guaranteed.